Hi, I'd like to talk a little bit today about what we see in the night sky and make it a little bit dark for that. We can see stars at night after the sunset because the sunlight during the day lights up the whole sky because of the molecules in the atmosphere refracting light and predominantly blue light in the sky. It makes the sky blue. At night the sun goes down, we can see through the atmosphere and see to stars very far away. And in addition, we can see the planets, and the ancient people could see these planets, and the thing they noticed about them, they called them wandering stars or other kinds of things, implying that they had some control over what they did and how they moved. The stars, on the other hand, were locked in place in constellations, and we can see that these constellations are the same ones seen over hundreds and even thousands of years, and the lines connecting the stars are completely arbitrary and the names are completely arbitrary. But many cultures have organized stars in this manner, in constellations. But the planets move among the stars in ways that can be complicated. And one of the complications we call retrograde motion. And that is where, over time, a planet moves in a straight path for a ways and then can undergo a loop. And as it does this loop, follows, and it will come back sort of along the path that it had just traveled for a few weeks and then come back the other direction, the way it normally goes. And so we call the normal motion the prograde motion and the backward motion retrograde motion. We see two cases of that here in for Mars in 2014 and in 2016. So what is the cause of this? And is this a problem? Well, it was a problem and a challenge for people who were thinking about the geocentric model, because if the Earth isn't moving and we see the planets moving as they are in the sky, and that's their actual motion as we see here, then this is pretty complicated and we have to explain it. And it became realized that there were mathematical ways that you could describe this, and this is what Ptolemy did using epicycles to think about the different loops that the different planets undergo here from time to time. However, in the geocentric model, then it's a kind of a challenge, but in the heliocentric model, the process is really sort of a natural consequence of the motion. So if we take a look here, with the geocentric model, we see the Earth in blue, not moving. And so the Sun goes around the Earth in a perfect circle, and there's no need for the sun to undergo any kind of strange motion like an epicycle. However, the planet Mars undergoes this strange loop right there for each orbit. And in the heliocentric model, we see this is a natural result of the fact that the Earth is moving and Mars is moving. So as if they're running on a track, the Earth in the inner lane moving a little bit faster, Mars in the outer lane not only has a further trip, but also it's moving a little bit slower than Earth. The Earth laps Mars, as we saw right there. And so every few cycles of the Earth, Mars gets lapped. Here it comes again. The lapping takes place. Now, when the lapping occurs, Mars appears to go backwards in the sky. So it's exactly the, what we have here. Just from the normal motion, a fairly simple viewpoint here, perfect circles in this case, the sun in the center, the heliocentric model, and that describes what we see here, the looping retrograde motion of Mars. Because the orbits are inclined with respect to each other a little bit, they're not all exactly in the same plane. Sometimes this motion is seen a little bit differently than other times. Here we see the looping motion, and there we see more of a zigzag motion. But whenever the movement of a planet is backwards, we call that retrograde motion. Ultimately, we have two descriptions, and it's not easy to decide which of these is absolutely correct, because both of them describe the motion fairly well. And it took some other astronomers a little more time to figure out the solution to which one of these is truly the correct solution, or what modifications might still need to be made to find the proper model for planets.